Speaker's questions, and I call on Deputy Dara Cleary on behalf of Fianna Fáil.
Thank you, John Corder. Taoiseach, on the 3rd of December, a private member's motion presented by my party came before the House calling for an international review of AirGrid's Grid 25 proposals, and in particular to examine the alternative and the notion of putting those proposals, those cables, underground where it was appropriate. Of course, the government used its majority in that evening to vote down that proposal. It responded with a motion that had the words in it that the government intended, and in quote, developing the national infrastructure in the national interest. There was no commitment in the government motion to acknowledge or to address the concerns of the communities concerned amongst a number of different routes. Indeed, Minister Rabbit, during that debate, repeated his mantra that GridLink was a huge infrastructure investment programme, and he said you cannot change that at the whim of a passing fashion. Your own comments, Taoiseach, when you were in the desert, you linked those opposing the project to immigration and the concerns around employment. Let's fast forward from 3rd December to the 28th of January. Minister Rabbit has performed a U-turn that'll get him a full 10 marks in Strictly Come Dancing, and you've announced an external panel. We welcome the panel. There are people of very high calibre and very sound judgment on it. There are no international experts on it, and there's no health expert on it to advise on the health side of things. Minister Rabbit has dismissed those health concerns. When he was asked about them, he said, there are none that I can find. Minister Riley has written to two ministers expressing concern about the health risks posed by electromagnetic fields. He said, as a doctor and as Minister for Health, he was worried about the health risks from such magnetic fields, and he quoted various experts. He wrote to Minister Hogan and Minister Rabbit. Minister Riley said, I recognise that this national infrastructure project is important,
but please.
I can't ignore the health concerns. Yet your panel proposes to ignore the health concerns. Taoiseach, there's huge confusion this morning about the status of this expert panel. Firstly, will they be reviewing the North East interconnector? Some of your deputies have said on Morning Ireland on local radios around the country this morning that they had a conversation with you last night to say it would be included. Yet Mr. Fintan Sly, the Chief Executive of Aircom, has said this morning that he is proceeding with the North East and intends to apply for planning permission. So can you clarify that? Minister Rabbit has also said that the North East will not be included. And secondly, Taoiseach, can you outline the government's thinking about the health side of the health concerns about this project, and have you any plans to include a health expert on the panel?
Thank you, Taoiseach. 3 minutes, thank you.
I'm surprised that Deputy Cleary, that he questions the capacity of the personnel appointed to this commission by Minister Rabbit. Is anybody suggesting that economist John Fitzgerald is not an independent mind, or economist Colin McCarthy? Is anybody indicating that Dr. Karen Foley, the head of School of Landscape Architecture in UCD, is not a competent person? Is anybody suggesting that the engineering professor Keith Bell of the University of Strathclyde is not internationally recognised as being a person of competence? And as you are well aware, Deputy Cleary, the opportunity for any commission appointed under the eminent retired Supreme Court Judge Catherine McGuinness has the opportunity to look for expertise where it needs it or where it feels it needs it. Now, the response given yesterday by the Minister for Energy was very clear. There were in excess of 30,000 applications and comments and observations made in respect of GridLink and GridWest. And in order to deal with the range of all of these observations, the Minister has appointed the Commission to look at all of these matters. And as he said himself in his own statement, it is important that when people look at an issue as important as this, that all of the issues that have to be attended to be set out very clearly indeed. There isn't an eminent medical person on this, but that's not to say that the McGuinness Commission can say we need medical expertise in the following area. I pointed out to Deputy Healy or Deputy one of the other deputies last week that Minister Riley did write to the Minister for Energy, expressing his concerns as expressed to him by people in his constituency. But that was about the undergrounding of the cable, which in the street of Rush is very close to some of the doors there. Minister Rabbit said himself, people need to be assured that the options they're being asked to consider are the right ones and that they are being given all the facts. And that's why the response yesterday, Deputy Colliery, was in respect of the proposals received for Grid Link and Grid West. Both of
Thank
these
you.
Are new proposals, as you're aware. Now, in regard to your question about the extension of the remit of the Commission to look at the context of the North-South connector, this is a project that's needed. This is a project that is critical piece of infrastructure for the development of the economy and business of the country for the years ahead. And the Minister has himself pointed out that he knows the public would be reassured if they knew that the overhead and the underground options have been investigated and that the already published studies are sufficient to enable a similar comparison to be made by both planners when they come to decide on the merits of the planning application. So Minister Rabbit's meeting with the chairperson on Friday to discuss the programme of work. That programme of work by AirGrid includes both Grid Link, Grid West and the North-South Interconnector, and I would like to see that the Commission would have its remit extended so that that can be analysed in the same way, with the same equality as all other areas in the country.
We have 1 minute, thank you.
Thank you, John Curran. Thank you, Taoiseach. Nobody questioned the capacity. I questioned the lack of a health expert within the core group, not somebody who will come in and give a presentation to them. Secondly, on the journal.ie in the last few minutes, Mr. Fintan Sly, the CEO of AirGrid, has said that he was not aware of a conversation between you and any deputies on the issue of the North-South Interconnector project. He stated work on that project was already underway. Planning permission will be applied for in the coming weeks. So instead of asking the chair of the commission to include the project, you're the Taoiseach. You set up this. Minister Rabbit has set up this. Can you not just tell them to include the project? Or else, this is what it looks like on the tin. An excuse, a pass to get you by the 23rd of May, to get your parties through the local election, and then nothing will change subsequently. So you can take control of this process. You can include the interconnector project in it now, and not pass the buck to George McGuinness.
Thank you. I don't accept that political assertion from you at all. As I've said here, people have had concerns and anxieties about this. Some were valid, some were not valid. I've always said in this House that what is needed here is the addressing of the challenge for the future, which you well recognise, and which has to be dealt with in a common sense and rational way. Now, the response of the Minister for Energy in respect of 30,000 submissions has been to set up the McGuinness Commission, an eminent retired Supreme Court judge with independent minds, both national and international, to look at all of the options, underground and overground, to publish them simultaneously so that everybody can understand that all of the issues have been taken into account. A great deal of work has been done on the North-South. It's going on for 8 years. There have been assessments, the completion of the commitment in the programme for government in respect of the analysis of undergrounding. But the criteria are being set now by the McGuinness Commission. And what I want, Deputy Colliery, for your information, is that the programme of work, well, that's discussed by the Minister with the chairperson on Friday, that because the response was different yesterday because of these two new propositions, that can be extended to the North-South interconnector as well, which is a critical piece of infrastructure which the country needs. You can only provide it one way or the other. We need to have all of the options, all of the facts examined there, and I hope that can be concluded when the Minister meets the Chairperson on Friday.